Silent assassin paddler Lin Yun Ju nails title of WTT Champions Frankfurt. US plans precision bombs transfer to Israel. Gaza death toll has hit 10,000. South Korea plans to launch its first military spy satellite on November 30. Israel says it is open to Gaza fighting pauses for aid and hostages. Partner countries owe China more than $1 trillion in Belt and Road debt. Mitsubishi Heavy expects record defense orders as Japan boosts military. Nobel Peace Prize laureate Narges Mohammadi goes on a hunger strike.
Hello, I'm Johnny. Thank you for joining us on Funday News. It's Wednesday, November 8th, and here are your top stories. Central News Agency reported Taiwanese table tennis player Lin Yun Ju reached a new milestone Sunday in Germany by lifting his first-ever World Table Tennis Champion trophy after upsetting China's Ma Long with 4-1 in the men's singles final of the WTT Champions Frankfurt 2023. Ma was widely regarded as one of the greatest players of all time. Lin said he never thought he would win the Frankfurt title, but noted that he took a different approach to the tourney that ended up paying dividends.
WTT Champions events are among the top events in professional table tennis and open to only the world's best 30 men and women and two wild cards, with a maximum of 4 players per member association. CNA said the tournament victory was Lin's second of the year, after winning the WTT contender Almaty 2023 in Kazakhstan in early September. Lin was quoted as saying on the WTT official website, "I think I had a good mindset because Ma Long is a super, super strong opponent."
South Korea said on Monday that it plans to launch its first domestically built spy satellite at the end of this month to better monitor rival North Korea, which is expanding its arsenal of nuclear weapons. South Korean Defense Ministry spokesperson Jong Hak-gu told reporters Monday that the country's first military spy satellite will be launched from California's Vandenberg Air Force Base on November 30th. The satellite will be carried by SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket.
According to South Korea's Defense Acquisition Program Administration, under a contract with SpaceX, South Korea plans to launch 4 more spy satellites by 2025. South Korea currently relies on U.S. military reconnaissance satellites to monitor moves by North Korea. However, these satellites are operated under U.S. strategic objectives, not South Korea's. The possession of its own spy satellites would give South Korea an independent space-based surveillance system to monitor North Korea in almost real time.
Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said Israel would consider tactical little pauses in Gaza fighting to facilitate the entry of aid or the exit of hostages, but again rejected calls for a general ceasefire despite growing international pressure. Speaking in a U.S. television interview, Netanyahu said he thought Israel would need security responsibility over the Palestinian enclave for an indefinite period after the war.
Asked about the potential for humanitarian pauses in fighting, an idea supported by Israel's top ally, the United States, Netanyahu said a general ceasefire would hamper his country's war effort. Netanyahu told ABC News on Monday, "As far as tactical little pauses, an hour here, an hour there, we've had them before. I suppose we'll check the circumstances in order to enable goods, humanitarian goods to come in, or our hostages, individual hostages, to leave. But I don't think there's going to be a general ceasefire."
A report released Monday by Aid Data, a research institute tracking development finance at Virginia's College of William & Mary, said China is owed more than $1 trillion through its Belt and Road project, making it the biggest debt collector in the world with an estimated 80% of the loans supporting countries in financial distress. Aid Data said Beijing had now committed aid and credit, hovering around $80 million a year, to low- and middle-income nations.
Aid Data said, total outstanding debt, including principal but excluding interest, from borrowers in the developing world to China is at least $1.1 trillion. A joint report this year by the World Bank and other institutions, including aid data, said Beijing had been forced to hand out billions of dollars in bailout loans to BRI countries in recent years. The report said, Beijing is navigating an unfamiliar and uncomfortable role as the world's largest official debt collector.
Mitsubishi Heavy Industries said Monday it has doubled its forecast for defense orders to a record 1.6 trillion yen in the current financial year as Japan expands its military by the most since World War II. The company on Monday also lifted estimates for total orders for the full year by around a fifth to 5.6 trillion yen. Mitsubishi Heavy CEO Seiji Izumisawa told reporters it had a rather conservative estimate and has seen bigger than expected orders for aircraft, defense, and space.
Tokyo has said it aims to double defense spending to 2% of gross domestic product by 2027 in response to an increasingly assertive China and North Korea. The country's top defense contractor Mitsubishi Heavy makes missiles, tanks, submarines, and other defense equipment. Military contracts account for around a tenth of its overall revenue. A company spokesperson told Reuters that the revised internal estimate for defense orders stood in contrast to the 800 billion to 850 billion yen that Mitsubishi Heavy had previously expected.
Nobel Peace Prize laureate Narges Mohammadi began a hunger strike Monday over being blocked along with other inmates from getting medical care. The Free Narges Mohammadi campaign, citing a statement from her family abroad, said she sent a message from Evin prison on Monday and informed her family that she started a hunger strike several hours ago. It said Mohammadi and her lawyer for weeks have sought her transfer to a specialist hospital for heart and lung care.
Days earlier, Mohammadi's family described her as suffering from blockages in three veins and lung pressure. Despite that, they said, prison officials refused to take Mohammadi to the hospital due to her refusal to wear the hijab. The statement read, Narges went on a hunger strike today, protesting two things: the Islamic Republic's policy of delaying and neglecting medical care for sick inmates, resulting in the loss of the health and lives of individuals. The policy of death or mandatory hijab for Iranian women.
The answer for yesterday was B, strategic. Strategic alliances are being forged with major European companies. Did you answer correctly? Now let's delve into the news of partner countries owing China more than $1 trillion in Belt and Road debt. Number one, hover. 靠近某事物处于不稳定状态. Temperatures hover around freezing. Number two, bailout. 紧急财政援助. The troubled insurer received the biggest government bailout in U.S. history. Number 3. Navigate. 找到正确的方法对付困难复杂的情况. We next had to navigate a complex network of committees. Next, we have a multiple choice question for everyone to practice. Which answer would you choose? You can write your answer in the comments section. The correct answer will be announced tomorrow. And that's all for today's Fun Day News. Be sure to tune into Fun Day News from Monday to Friday and click the link below to join Fun Day for free. I'm Johnny Wu, your host. I'll see you next time.